Good evening. Thanks for joining us. For 3 days, we've watched and waited. And tonight, we gather in the darkness of the grave, seeking the light of the Paschal Mystery. Out of the darkness, fire, a burning bush in the desert, calls us to stop, to remember that we are on holy ground. Then we remember. It comes back to us piece by piece. The story of God's unfailing salvation for the whole world until the last piece falls into place and suddenly Jesus meets us. Greetings. The light has shined in the darkness and the darkness has not overcome it. This is good news indeed.
Dear friends in Christ, on this most holy night, in which our Lord Jesus passed from death into life, the Church invites her members dispersed throughout the world to gather in vigil and prayer. For this is the Passover of the Lord, in which by hearing His word and celebrating His sacraments, we share in the victory over death. Let us pray. O God, through your Son, you have bestowed upon your people the brightness of your light. Sanctify this new fire, and grant that in this Paschal feast we may so burn with heavenly desires that with pure minds we may attain to the festival of everlasting light. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice now, heavenly hosts and choirs of angels, and let your trumpets shout salvation. For the victory of our mighty King. Rejoice and sing now, all the round earth, bright with a glorious splendor. For darkness has been vanquished by our eternal King. Rejoice and be glad now, Mother Church, and let your holy courts in radiant light resound with the praises of your people. All you who stand near this marvelous and holy flame, pray with me to God the Almighty, for the grace to sing the worthy praise of this great light. Through Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with him in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is truly right and good, always and everywhere, with our whole heart and mind and voice to praise you, the invisible, almighty, and eternal God, and your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb, who at the feast of the Passover paid for us the debt of Adam's sin, and by his blood delivered your faithful people. This is the night when you brought our forebears, the children of Israel, out of bondage in Egypt, and led them through the Red Sea on dry land. This is the night when all who believe in Christ are delivered from the gloom of sin and are restored to grace and holiness of life. This is the night when Christ broke the bonds of death and hell and rose victorious from the grave. How wonderful and beyond our knowing, O God, is your mercy and loving kindness to us, that to redeem a slave you gave a son. How holy is this night when wickedness is put to flight and sin is washed away. It restores innocence to the fallen and joy to those who mourn. It casts out pride and hatred and brings peace and concord. How blessed is this night when earth and heaven are joined and we are reconciled to God. Most holy God, accept our evening sacrifice, the offering of this candle in your honor. May it shine continually to drive away all darkness. May Christ, the morning star who knows no setting, find it ever burning. He who gives his light to all creation and who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Let us hear the record of God's saving deeds in history, how God saved people in ages past, and let us pray that our God will bring each of us to the fullness of redemption.
Can I tell you a story? In the beginning, when God created the heaven and the earth was formless, it was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the dark, and God called the light day, and the darkness God called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome sky, and there was evening and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together God called the seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees of every kind that bear fruit with the seed in it. And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with seed in them. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. And God said, let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night. Let them be for signs and seasons and for days and for years. Let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth. And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God said that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the dome of the sky. So God created the great sea monsters and every living creature that moves of every kind with which the waters swarm and every winged bird of every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them saying, be fruitful and multiply and fill the waters of the sea and let birds fill the skies. And there was evening and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things and wild things on the earth and of every kind. And it was so. And God made the wild animals of the earth and every kind and cattle of every kind and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have stewardship over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humankind in God's image. In the image of God, God created them, male and female, God created them. And God blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and steward it and have responsibility over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air and over the living things that move upon the earth. And God said, see, I've given you every plant yielding seed that's upon the face of the earth and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, and everything that has the breath of life, I've given every green plant for food. And it was so. And God saw everything that was made, and it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that God had done, and God rested on the seventh day from all the work that God had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work that God had done in creation. These are the generations of the heavens and of the earth when they were created. May none of God's wonderful works keep silence, night or morning,
bright stars, high mountains, the depths of the seas, sources of rushing rivers. May all these break into song as we sing to Creator, Savior, and Holy Spirit. May all the angels of the earth reply, Amen, Amen, Amen. Power and praise and honor and eternal glory to God, the only giver of grace. Amen, Amen, Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who wonderfully created and yet more wonderfully restored the dignity of human nature, grant that we may share the divine life of Him who humbled Himself to share our humanity, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
I want to tell you the story of when God delivered the Israelites from slavery in Egypt. They'd been in Egypt for years and they were trying to escape. They were very afraid and they looked behind them and saw that Pharaoh and his army was drawing near. And they cried out to God and they cried out to Moses, who was leading them through the wilderness. And they complained to Moses, "You should have left us in Egypt and left us as slaves. It would have been better to stay slaves than to die in the wilderness." But Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. God is going to provide deliverance for you like you cannot even imagine. And after tomorrow, you will never see these Egyptians again." And God said to Moses, "Tell the Israelites to go forward, but lift up your staff and raise your hand over the sea and divide it so the Israelites can pass through the sea on dry ground. I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians and they will follow you into the sea. But I will overtake Pharaoh and his chariots and his chariot drivers. They will not pass through the sea. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord your God. I will gain glory for myself when Pharaoh and the chariots and the chariot drivers die in the sea." The angel of God who was going before the Israelites took position behind the Israelites to protect them. And the pillar of cloud moved from in front of them to behind them. And this pillar stayed between the Egyptians and the Israelites all night, so that neither army drew near the other. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind all night and turned the sea into dry land. The waters were divided. The Israelites went into the sea on dry ground, the waters forming a wall on them, on their left and on their right. The Egyptians pursued and went into the sea after them, all of Pharaoh's horses, his chariots, and the chariot drivers. At the morning watch, the Lord in the pillar of fire and cloud looked upon the Egyptian army, threw the Egyptian army into panic. He clogged the chariot wheels so that they turned difficultly. The Egyptians said, "Let us flee from the Israelites, for the Lord is fighting against Egypt." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea so that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their chariot drivers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea returned to its normal depth. As the Egyptians fled before it, the Lord tossed the Egyptians into the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the chariot drivers, the entire army of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea. Not one of them remained. But the Israelites, they walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters forming a wall for them on their left and on their right. Thus, the Lord saved the Israelites that day from the Egyptians. And Israel saw that the Egyptians were dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great work that the Lord did against the Egyptians. So the people feared the Lord, and they believed in God and in His servant Moses. Then the prophet Miriam, Aaron and Moses' sister, took a tambourine. And all the women went out after her with their tambourines, and they danced, and they praised, and they sang, "Sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. Horse and rider, God has thrown into the sea." Wisdom, freed from a nation of oppressors, a holy people, and a blameless race. She entered the soul of the servant of the Lord, withstood dread rulers with wonders and signs. To the saints she gave the reward of their labors, and led them by a marvelous way. She was their shelter by day, and a blaze of stars by night. She brought them across the Red Sea, She led them through the mighty waters, but their enemies she swallowed in the waves and spewed them out from the depths of the abyss. And then, Lord, the righteous sang hymns to your name and praised with one voice your protecting hand. For wisdom opened the mouths of the mute and gave speech to the tongues of a newborn people.
Let us pray. O God, whose wonderful deeds of old shine forth even to our own day, you once delivered by the power of your mighty arm your chosen people from slavery under Pharaoh to be a sign for us of the salvation of all nations by the water of baptism. Grant that all the peoples of the earth may be numbered among the offspring of Abraham, and rejoice in the inheritance of Israel. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now, I would like to share with you a story of the prophet Ezekiel. Ezekiel said, "The hand of the Lord came upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in a valley. The valley was full of bones. God led me all around them. There were many bones lying in the valley, and they were very dry. God said to me, 'Mortal, can these bones live?' I said, 'Lord God, only you know.' Then God said to me, 'Prophesy to these bones. Be courageous. Lift up your voice. Say to them, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. I shall lay sinews on you, and will cause flesh to come upon you and skin to cover you. I will put breath in you and you shall live. And in this way you shall know that I am the Lord.' So I prophesied as I had been commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise, a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to bone. And I looked, and suddenly there were sinews on the bones and flesh and skin covering it all. But there was no breath in them. Then God said to me, 'Prophesy to the breath. Prophesy, mortal, and say to the breath, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these who have been slain, that they may live.' So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and they stood in the valley, a vast multitude." Then he said to me, then God said, "Mortal, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say, 'Our bones are dried up and our hope is lost. We are cut off completely.' Therefore, prophesy to them. Thus says the Lord God, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from your graves and bring you back to the land of Israel. That way you will know that I am the Lord. I will put my spirit in you, and you shall live, and I will place you on your own soil. Then you shall know that I, the Lord, have spoken, and I will act. Lord,
hear my prayer, and in your faithfulness, heed my supplications. Answer me in your righteousness. Enter not into judgment with your servant, for in your sight shall no living be justified. For my enemy has sought my life. He has crushed me to the ground. He has made me live in dark places like those who are long dead. My spirit faints within me. My heart within me is desolate. I remember the time past. I muse upon all your deeds. I consider the works of your hands. I spread out my hands to you. My soul grasps to you like a thirsty land. O Lord, make haste to answer me. My spirit fails me. Do not hide your face from me, or I shall be like those who go down to the pit. Let me hear of your loving kindness in the morning, for I put my trust in you. Show me the road that I must walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for I flee to you for refuge. Teach me to do what pleases you, for you are my God. Let your good spirit lead me on level ground. Revive me, O Lord, for your name's sake. For your righteousness' sake, bring me out of trouble. Of your goodness, destroy my enemies and bring all my foes to naught. For truly, I am your servant.
Let us pray. Almighty God, by the Passover of your Son, you have brought us out of sin into righteousness and out of death into life. Grant to those who are sealed by your Holy Spirit the will and the power to proclaim you to all the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Through the Paschal Mystery, dear friends, we are buried with Christ by baptism into his death and raised with him to newness of life. I call upon you, therefore, now that our Lenten observance is ended, to renew the solemn promises and vows of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and all his works and promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, Savior. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins,
the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to God?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed upon us the forgiveness of sins, keep us in eternal life by His grace, in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
There's one more story I want to share with you. I heard this from Matthew, who heard it from Mary. Now, I know that we saw Jesus crucified, but after the Sabbath, as the first light was breaking the new dawn, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to the tomb for vigil. Suddenly, the earth reeled and rocked underneath their feet as God's angel came down and stood right next to them. He then rolled away the stone from the tomb, and he sat on it. Shafts of lightning shone forth from his body, and his garments, they shone like the snow, brightest white snow. The guards of the tomb were frightened. They were so scared, they couldn't move. The angel spoke to the Marys. There's nothing to fear here. I know you're looking for Jesus, the one that they nailed to the cross, but he's not here. He's been raised, just like he told you. Come and look at the place where they laid him. Now get on your way quickly and tell his disciples he is risen from the dead. He's going to go on ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there. That's the message. The Mary's deep in wonder and full of joy. They lost no time in leaving the tomb. They ran to the disciples, and then Jesus met them, stopping them in their tracks. "Good morning," he said. They fell to their knees, and they wrapped their arms around his feet and worshiped him. And Jesus said, "You're holding on to me for dear life. Don't be frightened like that. Go tell my brothers. They're to go to Galilee, and there I will meet them."
Alleluia! Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia!
Alleluia! Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia!
Alleluia! Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
You.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, who made this most holy night to shine with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church that spirit of adoption which is given to us in baptism, that we, being renewed both in body and mind, may worship you in sincerity and truth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier, be with you always. We'll see you in the morning at 10 a.m. to continue our celebration of the risen Lord with a service of Holy Eucharist. Please join us. And in the meantime, the peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you. Alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.